each one of us for a mission, for a purpose. Philip was a man anointed by God, as we read in Acts chapter 6, to distribute food for the widows. That was the work was given by the apostles. But God had a greater mission. Sometimes we are caught up in a little world and we go through a lot of pain, problems, and we think everything is closed. The book of Revelation chapter 3 verse 8 says, if God, or when God opens the door for you, no one can close it. If God opens the door for you, nobody can close it. If God closes certain problems for you, nobody can reopen those problems. God will settle it. What a great God we have. And one day, Philip was praying. He is meant to distribute food for the widows. And he is praying. The Holy Spirit is telling, run to the road towards Samaria. So he is running. He did not know why he is running. And then God says, you move ahead. Always God wants us to go ahead in life. We think of our problem and we think we are caught up in a problem. Many of the times we remain in problem and we think God is somewhere far. And we say, Lord, please come and help us. Lord, I am caught up into problem. Please help me, save me. But God says, as we read in the book of Psalm 18, verse 28-29, O Lord, you brighten my darkness. And you brighten my darkness and you empower me to cross over the walls. Meaning, God doesn't want us to remain in a problem and call upon God, but God wants us to reach God, to be with God, and to be empowered by God, and to move into the world. There are three stages when we follow the Lord. The first stage, we call it a stage of devotion. And the second stage, we call it the stage of a disciple. And the third stage, we call it a stage of apostle. Yeah, devotee is one who seeks God. Please come and help me. I will give garland for you. I will give coconut for you. I will walk without chapel for you. I will fast for you. I will go to Velamini for you. I will do this, I will do that. What do you need to? Please help. I am in trouble. I am in situation. Please help. Who is he? He is a devotee. So devotee is one stands amidst the problem and look towards God as though God is somewhere else. Please come and help me, save me. I will do for you. There is another stage called a disciple. A disciple doesn't call God to be with him. A disciple is one moves to God to be with him. Disciple moves to God to be with God. And he enters where God is. He enters into God's life. He enters into God's power. He moves, Lord, here I am. Please take me. Take me into your goodness. Take me into your forgiveness. Take me into your light. I don't understand my life. Give me your light. Give me your wisdom. Give me your power. Take one example I'm telling you. Take Acts of the Apostles. In Acts chapter 4, we read where disciples, that is called Peter and John, they were being caught by the high priest. They beat him thoroughly and they said, "Don't ever say the name of Jesus." But they said, "We don't care. We have to do what God wants us to do." And they did not know what to do with these fellows. "Okay, get out. Don't speak about Jesus." They warned them and sent them away. Beaten, they have received beatings. So blood is oozing. With that, now we read verse 23 onwards. As soon as they went, they were freed. Peter and John returned to the other believers and told them what the leading priests and the elders have said. When they heard this report, all the believers lifted their voices together in prayer to God. They never asked God to deliver them from the problem. They are getting union with God. Verse 29, now Peter is praying. What is praying? "O Lord, hear the threats and give us, your servants, great boldness to preach your word. Stretch out your hands with the healing power of yours. Let miracles and signs and wonders take place, O Lord, in your name, Jesus." They are not asking, "Please save us." They are saying, "Lord, we are with you now. Your power is our power. Your glory is our glory. Your light is our light. So tell us what we need to do with your power. Why did you choose us?" Now, as they were praying, the Bible says, as they were praying, verse 31, the meeting place began to shake and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. And they were given the word to preach. They are in trouble. They were beaten up. But they move from a devotee saying that, "Lord, why this problem for me? Please save me from this problem." They never prayed like that. They were not devotees. "Lord, if you save us, I will come and give you 1,000 rupees somewhere." They never asked like that. They moved as a disciple. "Daddy, we are your children. How dare they can beat us, Daddy? Give us your strength. Give us your light. And make us to do what you want us to do. We are under your power. We are under your glory." They moved from asking God to deliver them from the problem. Now they are asking the Lord to join them with him and to do his work, his will. And when they started to pray, the place started to shook and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Now God is using them. Now God is leading them. And filled with the wisdom of God, they came to do the will of God. They become from disciple to apostles, ready to live for God, ready to die for God, ready to do whatever God wants them to do. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Our mighty God has a plan for each one of us. Our mighty God has chosen each one of us for a purpose, for a mission, and he is with us. And he will never leave us, nor forsaken us. And when Philip was saying, "Lord, here I am," the Lord Holy Spirit says, Philip never said, "Lord, please help me." No. Philip says, "Holy Spirit, I belong to you. Use me whatever you want." As he is praying, Holy Spirit lifted him and put him on the road. And there he sees a minister is going by the chariot. And he is reading the book of Isaiah. So Philip asked him, "Sir, did you understand?" He said, "Unless somebody comes and helps." So he got into the rhythm. And he got into the chariot. He explained about Jesus. And they saw the water. The minister said, "Why can't I receive baptism?" They got into the water. He baptized. Immediately the Holy Spirit snatched him, put his hand on the hair and lifted him and put him somewhere else. No more Philip is telling the Lord, "Lord, please help me." Now Philip realizes, "I am in the hands of God." This is what the Lord said in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 18, verse 6. The Lord said, "Like the clay in the hands of the potter, you are in my hands." Yes. Each one of us are like the clay in the hands of the potter. Maybe we are going through many situations which we don't understand. But if we look at the light of the Lord, we can have meaning for our lives. What does the potter do? He takes the mud. When he takes the mud begins to cry, "Why are you taking me? I am very safe in the ground." But he doesn't bother, because he is taking the mud for a purpose. He has to make a clay. You and I are like the clay in the hands of the master. So the master removes all the big stones, small stones away. Now only mud is left out. Mud is getting angry, fuming with anger. "With the stones I am very safe, security. Now you have removed everything." The master is not listening to the mud. He pours the water into it. The mud may be getting angry. "What do you think of me? You want to become water and become nobody?" Not only that, now the master gets into that mud and what does he do? He stamps over it. The mud says, "Nobody is available for you. You got only me. You are stepping me, throwing me. What is this?" And then he takes the clay and puts it in the wheel. The mud says, "Gone. I am gone. I don't know what is happening to me." Then he takes out that and puts it on the fire. "Oh no, this is the end of my life alone." But the potter takes out and puts color into it. Red, green, yellow, blue. And the king who is going on the way looks at the pot, beautiful. "Give me that pot. I want to keep it near the palace to keep nice flowers." The people who are going, one lady who is traveling, "Sir, sir, give me that. I want to keep cool water." Different people want. The mud there was somewhere is made by the potter in the same way. We are so happy with our little world, and we do not know what are the things God has given to us. What are the things God is doing through us? My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.